Hi, I'm Carrie Brown with Keysight Technologies. It's exciting to see the growing market in autonomous vehicles and the active safety products that are involved in that, like radars and camera, that help keep a driver safe and aware of their environment, have data rates that are growing exponentially. You're probably familiar with the lower speed digital buses that were used before, but have you considered the protocol complexity that's required for these new high-speed digital buses? The high-speed digital buses of today are really quite different. The automotive Ethernet looks quite different than CAN and LIN and most that you're used to looking at. For example, you're going to need to do compliance testing for the IEEE standards. You're also going to have to take a look at the protocol testing or the protocol side so that you can correlate that back to the physical bus. We're going to take a look at a setup I have here of an automotive Ethernet signal, both compliance and protocol. I have an Infinium 2.5 gigahertz oscilloscope. I have a device under test and some sample tests that we're going to take a look at. First things first, we're going to set up the compliance application to see if the signal will pass the transmission specification for IEEE. What we're looking at here is a 100-base T1 compliance application. You can see there's 9 total tests. These are defined by IEEE. Keysight also has a 1,000-base T1 application, and there are 14 total tests, so there's a couple of more tests there. I'm going to choose a couple of these tests, and we're going to walk through these tabs to see how the compliance application works. Under the Configure tab, I would select which channel my DUT is connected to. Under the Connection tab, you can actually see the oscilloscope connections with the SMA cables to the device under test. And that's for each specific test that's being run. Once you run the tests, you come back through to results. And here you can see the pass-fail margins associated with each of those. Now, I've run these tests already, and you can see that they have passed. And in addition to that, there's an HTML report that allows you to look through the details of the screens and email this report directly to another user. Next, we're going to take a look at the protocol side of things. We're going to go under Setup and choose Protocol Decode. Once we choose the type of protocol we want, we choose our data source. And just to show you what's available, I'm going to choose Manual Setup. Here you could choose your trigger levels and your protocol threshold levels, or the type of Ethernet packet that you'd like to trigger on specifically. For the sake of this example, we're going to use an auto sweep and actually use a waveform that I have already captured. And what you can see when we look at the data is this is the captured waveform from the device under test, and this is PAM3 signaling. We can decode that signaling and show the decode in the waveform as well as the packet listing here down below. The packet listing shows the UDP or TCP, and once we select a specific packet, we display the symbols associated with that packet over in the right-hand side. These windows are all customizable in size, and as I make this one bigger, you can see the details of this specific packet that I have chosen. The payload underneath that shows the actual bits that have been transferred. Those are the actual bits that are encoded, the actual data that was transferred. And underneath that is the header that shows you the specification layout. The compliance application you would use to test against the IEEE standards, and the protocol application you would use to correlate those back to the physical bus. Together, these tools give you an insurance policy to prevent costly, last-minute mistakes for you, or even worse, your customer. The automated compliance application, plus the protocol decode application, plus the Infinium oscilloscope that we looked at, is going to enable you to deliver high-quality, timely, manufacturable modules to the OEM and ultimately ensure safety for the cars of the future. You can visit the website that's listed on the screen for more information. Thanks for watching, and have a great day.